How to ruin your Tacoma in 5 easy steps. Well, good morning, everybody. How are you today? Pretty good here, and that's right. I'm going to tell you how to ruin your Toyota Tacoma in just 5 easy steps. Little mod sitting back there, speaking of things. Anyway, that's right. There are 5 easy steps that you can utilize to ruin your Toyota Tacoma. Now, obviously, this is a little bit of a satirical video. First of all, buy cheap parts. You know, if you're looking to ruin your Tacoma, buying cheap parts is probably one of the easiest ways you can do it, right? You know, there are a myriad of parts suppliers out there for the Toyota Tacoma. Aftermarket mods, even maintenance type parts, right? Make sure that you buy the cheapest parts that you can buy, because you can be guaranteed that they're not gonna have any kind of warranty, unlike the OEM Toyota parts, and that they're probably not gonna fit properly. And you might even have to improvise a little bit. You know, you might have to tweak something, maybe use a different bolt or screw. Maybe even put some duct tape or something on there. Buy cheap parts. Number 2, take internet advice at face value. Because you know there are a ton of experts out there, right? And you can find them everywhere. It's pretty easy to do. Join one of the many forums out there or many groups out there, and there'll be tons of people trying to tell you what you should and shouldn't do. Listen to every one of them, because you know they're all experts, right? They have experience. They've done it at least one time themselves. They know what they're talking about. I'll give you an example. Putting bigger wheels and tires on your Tacoma, they won't rub. Those people know what they're talking about. Now, they might eventually throw a little caveat in there. They might tell you that under certain circumstances, yeah, maybe they rub a little bit. But that's no big deal. They know what they're talking about. If it rubs now and then, it's not a big deal. Who cares? It still fits. Number 3, do all of the work yourself. No matter what your skill level or motivation level is, do it all yourself. You don't have to be an expert to put parts on your Toyota Tacoma. You don't need to own a torque wrench. I'm guilty of that. Just go ahead and do it. You really don't need any experience. I mean, you know, it's so easy these days that most of the cheap mods that you buy, cheap parts that you buy, they don't even come with instructions anymore. It's intuitive. It's like we're just born knowing how to do these things, right? Do all the work yourself and make sure you don't have the right tools either, because it doesn't matter. I mean, a screwdriver is a screwdriver, right? Why are there so many different sizes? It doesn't matter. Just pop that puppy in there and turn it. And if it strips the head a little bit, you know, on the screw that you're trying to put in that screwdriver really wasn't meant for, it doesn't matter. As long as you get it tight enough, you'll never have to take it out again. So who cares if you strip the head? It doesn't make any difference. No big deal. Number 4, use inferior shops with little or no experience. You know, if you're driving down the road and you see some business that has a sign outside that says they do lifts, they're experts at it. It doesn't matter if you're the first customer that's been in there or not, or if they specialize in something else, like maybe exhaust pipes. It's the same thing. They're both metal, right? I mean, if you're going in to have your truck lifted, it doesn't really matter if they've ever done one before or not. Who cares? As long as they charge you twice or maybe more of the price for it, and give you no estimate as to how long it's gonna take and as little warranty as possible, that's okay. It doesn't make any difference. As long as it's on the truck and when you drive it away, it's a little bit higher. Who cares how much higher? Use inferior shops. Number 5, don't have a plan. That's right. When you get your brand new Tacoma, you know, it's all shiny and new and you're gung-ho and ready to roll, you don't need a plan or anything. Just start buying parts and sticking them on. It doesn't matter if you put something on that you gotta take off later. That's what tools are for. Of course, if you strip the head, it might be a bit of a problem. An example of that are bigger wheels and tires once again. I love to go back to this. This is like my go-to because it seems so many people do it. You know, they go out, they get the bigger wheels and tires. They didn't do a lift or anything. And they go ahead and stick them on. But the problem is when they're driving down the freeway or maybe just making that turn in the neighborhood, they can't turn the wheel all the way. Why? Because it's hitting the fenders. That doesn't matter. You see, in this instance, you might have wanted to go ahead and do the lift first. I'm just saying. So what is my point in this video, right? I mean, I know there's folks sitting back that are going, hey guy, he's nuts. He doesn't know what he's talking about. Well, that's kind of the whole idea, right? You need to have a plan. You need to use shops that have experience. And don't be afraid to ask. You know, if you go into a shop and you ask them if they've ever done one of these before and they seem put off or offended that you're asking them, you're probably at the wrong shop, right? They should have pride in what they're doing. They should want to tell you all about their previous jobs. Get references, right? I mean, references, I don't know. I guess I don't hold a lot of value in them because what shop is going to give you a reference to contact of a dissatisfied customer? Probably none. You might even be calling their spouse. I don't know. Maybe their brother, their sister, who knows? So they don't hold a lot of value, but a shop should at least have some kind of a base of previous customers that they can connect you with, right? Take a look in the shop. Look around. Is it neat? Is it tidy? Do the workers look like they care about what they're doing? What do they look like? Are they dressed well or they look like they just crawled out of a hole somewhere? You know, there's a lot to be said about appearance and the people that are doing the work for you, right? I don't know. I would just check it out a bit, nose around a little. I've done that myself. Kind of walked around, seen what the guys are doing. Are they working? Are they talking about what they're going to do on Saturday? See, because I want them focusing on my job, not what they're going to do tomorrow. As far as parts go, of course you should buy superior parts when you can, which should be every time, right? I would even go as far as to say that you should buy genuine OEM parts. And there are a few reasons for that. One, they fit. Two, they were designed or engineered for your Tacoma. You know, and there's a reputation thing here too, right? I mean, if a Toyota sanctioned parts supplier is providing parts that don't fit, that doesn't reflect very well on the Toyota brand, right? So they have a little bit of motivation to make sure that they're providing parts that are proper, that fit, that are right for your truck. Warranty. You know, most, if not every, I think, Toyota OEM part I have bought comes with a one-year warranty. You know, if anything's wrong with it, you have some recourse. If you're buying parts from some overseas company that isn't going to be around tomorrow, what are you going to do next? I guess you're going to go back to the OEM, spend double the amount. Who knows? Anyway, I just wanted to get on here, kind of make a little bit of a satirical video about how to ruin your Tacoma in just 5 easy steps. And it's that easy. Don't fall for any of those. Make sure that you use good shops and buy good parts. Leave a comment. Let me know if you've ever bought a part before because it was cheaper. We all like to save money, right? And then discovered it doesn't fit or it simply just didn't work. I'd be curious to know. Also, real quick, if you're interested, I have 2 other channels. The first is Rob Motive JT, all about my 2020 Jeep Gladiator. And the second is Rob Motive Civic, all about my experiences with the Honda Civic Type R and the Honda Civic Sport Hatch. Check them out. If you're interested, please consider subscribing. Don't forget to click that notification bell so that you don't miss out on any upcoming videos. And do me a favor, smash that subscribe button on the way out. Thanks for watching. Stay safe out there. Bye.